It's always been an obligation for me. So it's not just like, I never kind of questioned what I was going to do, right, with my life. It was like I was given the need and desire to create images, and I started doing it, and then once I started doing it, I couldn't stop. And tattooing, which I feel like tattooing is a different version of that, because it's not just me. When you're painting, when you're designing, or whatever you're drawing, it's like a solitary situation, right? It's you and whatever you're going to do, and your mind, and your the little voice in your head. With tattooing, I think it's like you have... It's a collaborative art because it's a dialogue between not just myself and that client. So it's not just me creating these images. It requires that person to be equally as invested, you know, mentally, emotionally, physically, psychologically, into making this huge commitment, right, for the rest of their life. I kind of got the inspiration when, you know, studying and going to Italy and seeing the work of like a Michelangelo and Da Vinci, and the thing about these guys that they weren't just strictly artists or painters. They were, you know, designers. They were architects. They were craftsmen. They were inventors. So they kind of fused all those crafts of genres of visual media, if you would, to create work. So, how the Blvckscvle came about was the housing family that sponsored Michelangelo, the Medici family, and the tombs that were set during the Pope and the Vatican. They basically, when they buried them, he designed the dome of the surrounding structure to have a constant ray of light to shine over their tombs, and that's how the word was developed. And so, you know, it's used in like biblical choruses and songs and things like that, but that concept, you know, especially when you go physically in there and you're walking into that area and you see how he basically is able to control light through what he created, I think that's what drew me to kind of make that connection, because it's this man basically taking charge of nature and, you know, getting his stronghold through his craft to create, you know, something out of nothing.
Oh, more, nigga. This is sick right here. Jun Cha, baby!
Having black scale, and I think the aesthetic of the brand, and I believe the aesthetic of June's art really does have, like, you know, we don't shy away from the dark imagery. And I think being able to do that was really dope. And it was like a natural, organic thing for us to just, you know, come together and do something together, you know, whether it was a t-shirt or, you know, any type of garment. I think it was nice to be able to do something like that and be able to execute it the way we wanted to. So yeah, we approached him with an idea, allowed him to come up, you know, with like the graphic and the artwork, and then you know, we kind of just went back and forth on ideas and were able to come up with a few really, really nice pieces. And I'm excited for everyone to see him.
The artwork that we chose kind of tied in with the whole religious kind of theme, right? Because you're talking about, again, that relationship between religion and art that that's still kind of quote-unquote classical, but it's still relevant, right, today, because you see all these people, modern life, still reverting back to that imagery. And there's something about that whole, I don't think just visually about that genre, it's really about Because I feel like it's so hard to believe in that today, right? We have all these things that's telling us not to believe in that today. And yet people are still making that commitment with tattooing. So it's kind of interesting, I think.
It's like a way of expressing it without...
Right, and you know what? I think it personalizes their experience with that belief. And I think this collaboration is another version of that. I think it's on, of course, a darker side, because I personally think which of course Blvckscvle shares that relationship. It's like, I'm questioning, what is this? You know, what is this image of a Virgin Mary that I'm staring at, or Jesus Christ? Like, why is this relevant for today? You know, why is this, what is it about this imagery that's making me personally invested into continuing to portray it? I was always driven because I was just insanely fascinated by art, and I wanted to learn, and every day is a learning process, and that never ever stops. And the day you think you're gonna figure it out, then that's gonna be the day that it's all over, you know? So it's like, I would just say to stress on focusing and just being humble about it, you know, and just loving what you do. I am young, but I've been blessed to have amazing people to look up to in tattooing, and that's one of the things they stressed. They said, you know, you can't take short. There's no way to take a shortcut into trying to perfect your craft. And honestly, it's like, I still have a long way to go.